who I talk to, they're not a good match. They're not someone who should be dating. And they need to know that the reason why they maybe they haven't been successful is because there's some other things, maybe some self-healing things that need to take place before mm-hmm. they can be in a relationship. Because now, when we're not healed, when we're not whole, we can't be functional in a relationship and have good results.
Right. You know? I think that's so important. And I think that that's one of the things that people don't really realize, right? I think a lot of times people go into relationships with this notion of finding my other half. And that leads the mind to think that you as your own are not a whole person. And the way I look at it, it should be two whole people coming together to like rule the world. Like, I'm a movement by myself, but I'm a force when we're together. That fabulous song from back in the day. But it shouldn't be, you know, it's two half people. Maybe we can put these two broken puzzle pieces together and you can come and fill in this void that I have. And I feel like when you do that, you damage each other almost.
Yeah. You definitely need to be 100% when you go into a relationship. You're right. It's not 50-50. You know, it's not, you can't get half, you know, you can't be partially invested. You have to be 100% invested, bringing your 100% self, doing your 100% A game, so that now it's not 100%, it's a 200% force that's going on in this relationship, right? So yeah, definitely 100, you're whole by yourself, but like you said, man, we're a force and we're together. Right? So you're complete. It's not that this person completes you. You already are complete. But what this person does is they add on to you. They add so much more. They complement you. Like, you know what I mean? It's like that that one accessory that you have when you go out and it's like a showstopper. Well, your dating partner is right. Such a compliment to you that when you guys go out, people are like,
Who are they?
Exactly.
Is that Barack and Michelle?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, no, honey, that's Michelle, it. But okay.
That's it. They complement each other. So that's exactly my point. Yeah.
So I'm wondering, when we're looking at ourselves and doing this self-evaluation to see, are we ready to go into dating? What are some of the things that you recommend people do to check themselves?
The first thing I'm always asking is your history, your relationship history. When I'm asking that question, what I'm looking for is the gap. Mm-hmm. If you don't have a gap in your dating history, you're constantly from one relationship to the next relationship, to the next relationship, to the next. You really don't know who you are as an individual. Yeah. There should always be a time and space for you to self-reflect, for you to heal, for you to get everything together before you go into that next relationship, so that you don't take any of that baggage from the previous relationship into this new relationship. Yeah. This new relationship should be a clean slate, and any mistakes that happen in that relationship should be its own mistakes, not the mistakes from the past. So when someone tells me that they haven't been single, that's such a red flag to me. So why do you feel that you constantly need to be in a relationship? What are you running away from?
And that's the key question, because I think that oftentimes there's this period of silence, right? Especially after you just end something, and there's all the thoughts running through your head, and there's the scenarios, and it's human nature to want to silence those thoughts and not want to deal with them. And so people deal with that in a number of ways, whether you jump into another situation or you have other sort of coping mechanisms. And the magic happens though when we're able to sit with those thoughts and listen to them and really realize what am I feeling bad about? What's that voice in my head saying? Why didn't this past relationship work out? What did that person do? Because, you know, maybe you hurt a person, they hurt you. Look at how you feel about that and evaluate it. I think it's so important to like sit in that space. And even if you were, you know, the person that was hurt, just looking at, being able to look at too, like, why did I stay? Or like, what is going on with me internally so that I can heal me before I go looking for someone else to do that? Like, relationships start, I'm not dating, you know, the doctor love, expecting the next person to come heal me or fix me. I'm dating, you know, to give and receive.
Yeah. And so you said something in between that was really important too, because even though you may not be in a relationship, it's not that you are lonely because you are alone, but this is the time to date yourself. This is the time to explore new things that you haven't done before. This is the time to really enjoy your own company.
Right.
Yeah.
And I think there's something to be said with enjoying your own space and your own company. And I know that some people are introverted, other, and so that may be a little easier for them, and others are more extroverted. But I think that you're so right in spending that time with yourself. You're able to discover your wants, your needs, what you like to do, explore new hobbies, and just get in tune with yourself. Like, it's kind of like fasting from food almost. You're able to kind of bring it in almost on a mental level and think like, all right, what's going on, and what is God, the universe, like whatever you guys believe in, trying to say to me.
Right.
And I think that